It's not that some people have willpower and some don't. It's that some people are ready to change and others are not. With these words, welcome you all to ABS Creations by your educationalist Chandrakala. My goal for reform is not necessarily to pass laws, but to make sure that laws are being followed. If you have not subscribed the channel, subscribe the channel by pressing the bell icon to receive the notification. In this session, we are going to learn about how can parties be reformed. In the previous video, we have discussed about what are the challenges faced by the political parties. The challenges faced by the political parties are lack of internal democracy, dynastic succession, role of money and muscle power, and no meaningful choices is given to the voters. So in order to face all these challenges, the political parties needed to be reformed. The political parties need to be reformed. So there arises a question, are political parties, whatever the political parties are there in a particular countries of the world, whether they are willing to reform? If they are willing, what has prevented them from reforming so far? If they are not willing, is it possible to force them to reform? So we as a citizen of a democratic country, we have to think of all these questions based on the challenges faced by the political parties. So in any democratic country, the final decision is taken by the leaders who represent the political parties. In any democratic country, the final decision is taken by the political leader who represent the political parties. So if the decision taken by the leader who represent the political parties is not liked by the people can replace them. So the dissatisfaction of the political leader, will make the people to replace them, but only by another set of party leaders. So when there is a dissatisfaction of that particular political party, the people can replace them, but only by another set of party leaders. So in such cases, there are certain efforts and the suggestions to reform political parties and the leaders of the political parties. So now we'll see what are the reforms or the efforts taken or the suggestions to reform political parties and the leaders of the political parties. The first major reform is that The constitution was amended to prevent elected MLAs and MPs from changing the political parties. Before the amendment of the constitution, the MLAs and the MPs, they shift from one party to the other party after they have won the majority number of seats and have become the ministers as MLAs or MPs. But the constitution was amended to prevent the elected MLAs and MPs from changing the parties. So elected representatives were indulging in defection in order to become ministers or for the cash rewards. Mainly for what? Ministers, to become a ministers or for a cash rewards. They move shift from one party to the other party. Either to become a minister, when we move shift from one political party to the other political party, the other political party may give a chance for that particular representative to become a minister or otherwise to win a cash award. So the word, particular word defection, what is the meaning of the word defection? Changing party allegiance from the party on which a person got elected to a legislative body to a different party. So for example, if a person A has won the majority number of seats in the party A, a person, when he wins a majority number of seats depending upon one party, after he has become a legislative body, member of the legislative body, so he shifts to a different party. For what purpose? Either to become a minister or to reward a cash. So that is what we say it as a defection. So law says that if any MLA or MP changes the party, he or she will lose the seat in the legislature. So automatically, when the constitution was amended, So according to the law, anti-defection law, it states that any MLAs or MP who changes the party after winning the majority number of seats, he or she will lose the seat in the legislature. So because of this anti-defection law, the MLAs and the MPs accept whatever the party leaders decide. So the main reform taken by the government by the constitutional amendment is that anti-defection law. So that is no party, no member of the legislative assembly or the member of the parliament, they can change the party from one party to the other party. If they do so, they will lose their seat in the legislature. So this is one of the major reform taken for the political party as well as the political leaders. The next major reform is that Supreme Court. The Supreme Court, they has passed an order to reduce the influence of money and the criminals. The Supreme Court has passed an order to reduce the influence of money and the criminals. So for example, during the election process, it is under practice also. So it is mandatory for every candidate who contests in election. A person who contests in election, they have to file an affidavit. They have to file an affidavit giving the details of his property and criminal cases pending against him. So for example, you can see the picture. So you can see the image of this format here. So here, this is an affidavit to fill the details of the particular person's property and the criminal cases pending against them. He or she has to submit this to the Election Commission of India. So the Supreme Court, it has passed an order to reduce the influence of money and criminals. How it has passed an order to reduce the influence of money and criminals? That is, whoever is contesting in an election, they have to file an affidavit giving details of his own property and the criminal cases pending against him. So this new system, so before that affidavit, what is that affidavit here? A signed document, that is a legal document submitted to an officer where a person can make a sworn statement regarding her personal information. So legally it is accepted that this property of that person belongs to this person. So this is what we say it as an affidavit. So with the help of this reform measure, lot of information is available to the public. But even though this reform measures has been taken, so that is submitting the affidavit giving details of his property and the criminal cases pending against him. So whether there is a system of check here, so it is not clearly said that there is a system of check. No system of check if the information given by the candidate is true. So even though the measure has been taken by the Supreme Court by passing an order to reduce the influence of money and criminals, there is no system of check for the information submitted by the candidate whether it is true or not. So this is the second suggestion to reform the political parties and the leader. The third suggestion is that the order which has been passed by the Election Commission. So the Election Commission of India, they have passed an order for the political parties. What is that order is that they should hold their organizational elections. We have seen in the lack of internal democracy. So they should conduct an organization elections and even they have to file their income tax return. So the order of Election Commission is that the political parties, they have to hold their organizational elections and they have to file their income tax returns. So these are the different efforts and the suggestions to reform political parties and as well as the leaders. The first one is what? The constitutional amendment, that is anti-defection law. The constitutional amendment was taken place to prevent the elected MLAs and MPs to shifting from one party to the other party. The second reform measure is that the Supreme Court, it has passed an order to reduce the influence of money and the criminals. The third one is what? The Election Commission of India has ordered or passed an order to the political parties to hold the organizational elections and file their income tax return. Besides these reform measures, So there are other suggestions which is often made to reform the political parties, but these reform measures, the suggestions for these reform measures to the political parties have not been accepted by the political parties. So here we can see that the law, first major thing you should remember, a law should be made to regulate the internal affairs of the political parties. So that is, we have seen the first challenge faced by the political party, lack of internal democracy. A law has to be prepared to regulate the internal affairs of the political parties. So each and every political party, they have to maintain a register of its members, as well as they should follow their own constitution. That is, the rules and the regulations followed based on their political party. They have to follow their own constitution. So they have to have an independent authority. They should act as a judge in case of any party disputes. When a dispute arises within the political party, the political party should act as a judge to resolve the problem. And also, it should hold open elections to the higher post. So this is what the first suggestion for reform measures of the political parties alone. So what is that? A law should be made to regulate the internal affairs of the political parties. So they have to maintain what? The register of its members. They have to follow its own constitution. They have to be an independent authority. They should act as a judge in case of party dispute. And they have to hold open elections to the higher post. The second reform measure for the political party alone is that reservation of tickets. Reservation of what? Tickets. 1/3 of the seats have to be allotted for the women candidates. So the political party, they have to allot 1/3 of the seats for the women candidates. And even quota for women, for decision making bodies, has to be allotted for the women category. So that is the second reform measures. The third reform measure is that there should be a state funding of elections. The government should give parties money to support the election. During the election process, the government should provide the party, should provide the money to that particular political party. So every political party will not get a cash in hand. They may get the fund provided by the government in the form of petrol, in the form of paper, in the form of telephone. So one and only when the cash is given to the political party means the cash is given on the basis of the votes secured by the party in the last election. So the state funding of election, the third suggestion is that state funding of election. The government, they should give parties money to support the election. So this support can be in the form of petrol, paper, telephone. But cash can be given on the basis of the votes secured by the party in the last election. So these are the suggestions often made to reform the political parties, but these suggestions have not been accepted by the political parties. If these political parties have accepted, it may lead to some improvement. Apart from these measures, there are other reform measures for a political party. So what are the other reform measures for a political party is that the people, they can put pressure on political parties. The people can put pressure on the political parties. How they can put pressure on the political parties means through petitions, through agitations, and through publicity. So people can put pressure on the political parties and raise an issue through the form of petitions, agitation, and the publicity. So in such cases, ordinary citizens, media, and pressure group and movement, they play a very important role by putting a pressure on the political party. So ordinary citizens, media, pressure group and movements, if they are against the political party, so the political party may have a fear in the mind that they will lose the public support. If the political party start feeling that they lose the public support, automatically they will think about the reform measures. If they are not taking any reform measures, they will lose the public support. The next other thing is what? The political parties can be improved if they join with the other parties. Political parties can improve if they join, those who want to join with the other political parties. So the quality of democracy, mainly the quality of democracy, what does it depends upon means it depends on the degree of public participation. Quality of democracy, it depends upon degree of public participation. So it is very difficult to reform political parties if ordinary citizens do not take part in it and simply criticize it from the outside. So we as a citizen of India, we have to publicly participate to make the democracy in a best manner. So if to reform political parties, we as an ordinary citizen, we have to take part in it in the form of voters as well as their contestors. So if you are not taking part in public participation, so and we are simply criticizing it from the outside, it is not possible for a political party to make some changes in it. So a degree of public participation makes the democracy a best one. So these are the other reform measures for the political parties. So three concepts of reform measures here. The one is that the efforts have taken and the suggestions have given to reform political parties and the political leaders. The second concept is that even though suggestions were made to reform political parties, all these suggestions have not yet been accepted by the political parties. Then what are the other? To make the quality of democracy a best one, the political parties have to be reformed. So I think you have understood the concept here. Just go through the questions and test yourself. Define defection and affidavit. Explain the reforms implemented in our country to improve the political parties. List out the suggestions often made to reform political parties. What are the other ways in which political parties can be reformed? So in the description box, I have given the link of the previous concepts of the political parties. You can go through and you can understand the concepts in a clear manner. If you like this video, you can subscribe it, share it, like it, comment it. Thank you.